Chris Chinnock here for Insight Media here in Display Week 2023. This is the PlayNitride booth. I'm going to show you their microLED solutions. Take a look. So what you're seeing here is their, I don't know what to call it, some kind of a waterfall kind of display. It's very tall, obviously. I think they said it was about 163 inches or so. 160 inches, yep, using 324 modules. It's set to about 2,000 nits of brightness, and you can see sometimes it's saturating the camera here, even though I slowed it down, slowed the aperture down. So it can go higher, obviously. And this is, they're taking commercial orders for this already, because this can be integrated into any kind of signage solution. This one happens to be a 0.83 millimeter pitch, so kind of a sweet spot of the fine pitch LED displays. So they had a device like this, except it was a horizontal banner last year in the PlayNitride booth. That was based on a 0.43 inch pixel pitch, of 0.43 millimeter pitch. Let's go take a look at that next. So here are the 0.43 inch modules that were actually from last year's display that they kind of repackaged in this kind of fun little box here. So it's a four-sided box with the coordinated images on it. Very nice. Here's some of the specifications on this particular device here. I guess I've turned the aperture down so it doesn't zoom out the display, but that says it's a 360 by 480 module with a seamless tiling exercise. Over here is a bunch of watches that they are putting together. These are on glass but passive matrix backplanes. I'm told there are actually several different configurations of these watches here. Let's see, these are primarily 256 by 256, but they hope that they can get to 384 by 384 soon. One type here is RGB discrete devices on the backplane, but the other is quantum dot color converted. And they've got two different color converted versions here. One is using cadmium-based quantum dots and the other cadmium-free or indium phosphide quantum dots. And so these are 0.11 millimeter pitch, 24-bit color depth. It says it's collaboration with Panasonic. Didn't see that before. 256 by 256, 1.58 inch. I guess it's diagonal. PlayNitride says that one of the advantages of the passive matrix devices here is that they're lower cost than active matrix and faster lead times for development purposes. And it's higher resolution than OLED displays as well. We'll take a look at their microLED on CMOS backplane. This is similar to the device they showed last year, 0.49 inch full HD with 4500 PPI. What's different from what they showed last year is the addition of a color filter to get a little bit better color purity on it. I believe this is quantum dot color converted, isn't it? Yes, that's correct. And they're showing it then in two different waveguide implementations here. Obviously, it's going to be difficult to see this through the camera here. This one is does not show very good color saturation. I'm told that was an artifact of the waveguide itself. This other waveguide is a lot brighter than the other one, but this waveguide has also got lots of structural artifacts as well. This is a 2D pupil expansion. The other one's, this is a 1D pupil expansion. The other was a 2D pupil expansion. So yeah, need a little work with their waveguide partners, but they're not a waveguide company, so they're to be forgiven. That's Chris Chinnock for Insight Media.